one of the interesting things is that people have been smoking for a very, very long time. And smoking goes back to long before tobacco actually came across in North America. One of the questions is, where does the traditional water pipe that you see across the Middle East, that one has in East Asia and so on, which has been used to volatilize all manner of beautiful natural products. It's been used for opium, it's been used for cannabis, and of course it's been used for nicotine. Where did that come from? It turns out that there are all kinds of pipes that you find in archaeological remains throughout Africa. And they come, the remains that are found come in two essential designs. And one is this, which are these bent elbow pipes. And their chronology indicates that they were pretty well exclusively used for tobacco. So essentially, it's just like your regular pipe. You put the tobacco in the top, you light it, and then you sort of suck it through the other side. The other thing are other, much smaller objects, and you can see them there. They look like little bowls, often with a bowl shape underneath. And for a very long time, these seemed to be very, very mysterious. And people thought they might be sort of little cups that people maybe sort of ate small offerings in or whatever. Until someone spotted that there was actually a hole connecting the top and the bottom. And that's when they began to realize that from some time around the 11th century in Africa, people were smoking stuff using these kinds of devices. And looking at modern pipes, they realized that that's where the bong came from. Is the bong is actually an African invention that is the oldest sort of example that's ever been seen. And the idea is simple, that what you do is you place lit charcoal on top of your assembly, you have water underneath. Now let's just see if we can cause an accident and break this. If you lift this out, we've got a bit of water, which I should be able to pour onto my laptop. Oh, it'll be great. It'll be so much better if it falls on my laptop.
Or your phone.
Or my phone, yeah, good point. No, it shouldn't. You should have vetted this whole thing. And so at this point, you can put this on the top, and what you do is you suck the smoke through. And as you do so, you go through the water, and what the water does is several things. One is it cools everything down. And secondly, it captures some of the more sort of water-soluble, and particularly some of the acrid components in the mix. Now the interesting thing is that the cannabis, the active molecules in cannabis, and we've been mentioning things like THC, so let me just put the picture up here. It's worth looking at this molecule because there is this long sort of dangly chain, and that, to a chemist, looks distinctly oily. It's the kind of thing which is unlikely to dissolve in water, and you'll notice that most of the rest of the molecule is actually pretty oily in character, apart from that OH. So by heating up the stuff here in the charcoal, you warm it up, but not to a sufficient temperature. To a sufficient temperature, you actually get it into the gas phase. You form, in fact, tiny little droplets, which you can then draw through the pipe, but they're not going to dissolve in the water. And so ultimately, they get to your lungs. Now, these are fine. There have been lots of modern developments. Here is a small one that I bought in Camden Market.
And if you want to see any of these demonstrated, by the way, just this evening when you finished here, drive down the Edgware Road in London, because every second cafe has these contraptions out on the table for people to use.
Well, I thought we should build one for ourselves, and I went digging around in the lab to see what interesting glassware I could find. And I was hoping that what we might be able to do was to get an improved, a kind of refinement of the traditional, to try and extract as much of that horrible vaporous, sort of acrid stuff as we could. And so what we have here is a chamber, and you'll notice that it's got an internal section there, and you'll see the effect in a moment. So let me just get this on top here. Okay, so we've got plenty of water. Then we're gonna put the top tube here. You may be wondering why it's so long. We'll come to that in a sec. Of course, we could put our charcoal burner on the front here, I had a hell of a time this morning desperately trying to glass blow this bit here. Anyway, we succeeded. We could conceivably put our charcoal on there. It'll probably break. But what I'm going to do now is inhale, and I hope you can see that now we get lots of those. And so what that means is that we're going to be able to actually clean up our smoke a lot more than we would have done otherwise. And so the basic idea is that when you smoke this stuff, you actually remove some of the undesirable components. And that's not really a big surprise when you think about cigarette smoking. Most cigarettes, in fact, come with a filter on the front. And this is just a kind of variant on that. But the basic idea is you take the temperature up just high enough to be able to volatilize it, not high enough that the whole thing catches fire, otherwise you lose all those great things. And they reach your lungs.